Yo, what is up, YouTubers? It is your boy ManXYZ bringing you another Sparrow Knights video. This time with my friend Rog Monster, aka Rog the Monster. Like, I'm always gonna call him that still, because he's a monster. But, you know, we're gonna be teaching you guys, you know, some tips and techniques to use in FSC to help you get through it quicker and more efficiently while keeping your health bars intact for the most part. Like, there are different methods that you guys can use, especially when it comes to like using different battle sprites, like the Draken, the Masquerade, and the Seraphinx. They can all be used in different ways, so I'll leave the Draken users up to Rog so he can guide you guys with things that you guys can do. I'll be leading the Masquerade users and teaching you guys techniques that you can use to help make the experience a lot quicker and easier. So first off, as you guys know, the most optimal weapons to use here are mostly elemental weapons, and then of course Blitzneedle for the boss. Most people ask me which one is better, Blitzneedle and Plague Needle, and my personal opinion is Blitzneedle is simply better just because it does more damage solid compared to when the Plague Needle does more, like, does damage while poisoned. Like, even if the opponent is poisoned, the Plague Needle still does less damage than a Blitz. But it's like if the opponent is poisoned and you're using a Blitz, it does even more damage. Plus, you can use your Vials, and if you have a Masquerade, you can use your Quills, so having no poison on your needle is not really that much of a disadvantage, because you can always just put your own down. And then besides that, I'd recommend Voltage or Glacius. Hammer is pretty nice for dashing around turrets and the Trojans. BTB is also pretty decent to sneak behind them, also pick off the Wolvers. Argent Peacemaker and Arcana is pretty decent. Any of the elemental drivers here work besides the Magma. Pretty much, I mean, unless you don't rely on a status, but you may as well be using Nova then. Polaris is alright, though you don't really have that many chances to take advantage of the knockback. Like, you're mostly in close quarter fights, except for Depth 26 at the beginning. And then, in terms of bombs, you guys are looking closer to the Electron Vortex, that'll help you a lot. Venom Veiler is quite nice. Stagger and Shiver also get the job done, though Stagger is mostly outclassed by Shiver, I would say, just because it's more usable on the boss. But yeah, those are the kind of weapons that you guys want to be using. In terms of gear, you just want to have maximum or ultra CTR on your Blitzneedle, and then a whole bunch of speed for your gun, so you're not standing there for too long after you release a charge on your Blitz. So I highly recommend Swift Strike Buckler. You don't really need to rely on your shield too much here if you know what you're doing. Is Rog AFK or is he here? I don't know. Well, I have a sandwich, I'm just eating. I'm just chilling right now. I'll show you guys the Masquerade techniques, boy. Might as well just go feed my Dragon Balls real quick, though. Okay. So you guys are ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So for him, he's probably just going to use his backfire barrier and just boost up.
Yeah, the first thing I would recommend for dropping users is to take a lot of advantage of your back barrier. That gives you a boost. It helps you a lot. Just like this.
Mm-hmm. And that allows you to pretty much speed up and just leave everyone behind the dust rip. Pretty much most of the time. And doesn't it also give you like an attack boost?
Yeah, it does, kind of.
Yeah. Oh, that vortex you put, bro. I'm dying. It's okay. But yeah, the vortex is really good for sucking monsters together and then just simply combining everything into one. You can just smack it once with a charge. You can even use the hammer and just dash through them. I mean, if you want to speed through it, we can just speed through it if you want. Like, you guys know what's at the bottom here. There's more monsters. You can go ahead and kill them off if you want. If you want to speed, you can just simply go on ahead up to here. Now, the technique here, if you guys just want to keep on putting down the statues, is when you're on the left side, you can simply put one statue in front of the wheel because it does block it, and you can go ahead and put the third one down, and then on your way back, you can move it. So that pretty much saves you one turn of potentially being hit. And then, meanwhile, he is just going to go ahead and clear up the slags. It doesn't matter if they die permanently or not, you still get the loot. and then you just go on ahead. Sadly, you can't break the wheels anymore like you used to. You can just skip through the middle here. It's normally nice to remove this totem just so that pesky slags that are in the way can potentially revive if you kill them. But like the other ones are fine to keep there, like they're not near. Oh, can I make it by here? I don't know. Okay, let's see. So here's a good part for Mask Wraith users to use their cloak, especially if they're on low health, like I am right now, because it allows you to bypass pretty much everything without being detected. And then from there you can just set up safely and just spam your charges without taking damage until you can just get your health up, so that's nice.
So another thing I would recommend is when you are in this part, just simply like run up with your vortex instead of just put in here and then go back, because that saves seconds, but it's whatever.
So what he does there is he sets his vortex up top and he goes for the charge. Meanwhile, I'm getting ready to set one at the bottom, because I know that after the slags die, the next wave starts. That time it wasn't as efficient, he never managed to kill all of them at once, I think it was like a bad spawn. But like 90% of the time you're able to like get everything in one charge from the top. Don't kill me. But yeah, normally you're able to get everything in one charge. What he's gonna do is go for the double here. He was just slightly a bit too far to the right, but normally he can nail that, so he'll show you guys later on, like you'll have more chances to do the double. And like what that is like you're just offsetting your charge so that you can hit both of them, both children, one charge. Yo.
The 24, the double is the hardest, but then it's just really easy.
Yeah, because like there's more spaces for the Trojans to spawn, so sometimes it doesn't go the way you want it. Alright. Is there anything else I want to mention? Nothing really about this level. This level is pretty simple. Is the next level where you really want to talk about?
Speed up things.
Mm-hmm. Strazav is weird at times, bro. He changed his name to initials. I'm like, who are you? He's like, you don't even talk to me anymore. I'm like, who are you? He's like, it's Strazav. I'm like, oh, hey, I didn't even know who you were, so why would I be talking? You know, and I'm not even dissing. It's just like, if I don't know who you are, then... Okay, so...
These loadings rip.
Damn. These loading speeds are pretty crazy, still.
So where do you want to go first?
Alright, I'm back. Just had the AFK real quick. So, did you say what you wanted to say?
Yeah, but where are you gonna go? Like, I can teach this room up here.
Okay.
So if you want to blitz, what you want to do is simply...
Normally go to the blitz. Like, I normally blitz first thing. Some people set down the... But yeah, you can just go, normally go right up. Should I just take him out? I'll just do that. But like normally what you'd want to do is like I'd really like to show them, but like what you'd normally do is you go straight up or like to the side, either one, either straight or the side, as long as you aggro one of the slags and then aggro the Trojan at the same time, and then you go around and just take him out. That's how you want to do it.
Pretty much lure him in.
Yeah.
And then
Oh no, I left some crowns.
Also, my recommendation is, to finish every room. You want to go leave like this right down here. That's just my view. I'm going to do it or not.
And true, so you can count it.
Also, mini.
Yo.
I found here that you can easily just blitz this like this. It's way fast.
Nice. So as you guys seen there, that's another technique you guys can use. Oh wow. Okay, how do you want to deal with this? I don't have anything I can really deal with this guy with, to be honest.
Dash.
Nah, it's not gonna work. I need to think of something else. I have nothing I can use to kill him, to be honest. I'm just gonna take it for the team. Don't worry. I'll just play with it. It's alright, I know how to dodge it.
For real. Yeah. Yo, we should repeat this.
I'm not really worried, to be honest. I'm just doing this nonchalant. Like, it's not like I'm trying to like prove a point saying I can do this without dying or whatnot. If me and you were trying to do a speedrun or trying to do it no deaths, we would be playing differently. Like, we're just trying to play it in a way where we can show what we're doing, so it's a bit different. Normally we don't even talk when we do the runs, to be honest. We just like know what we're doing and just go straight for it. Like, see, we have our combinations and stuff, like we don't even need to say anything.
True.
So I mean, I'm not worried about like, you know, deaths and whatnot.
You can do your favorite room.
Alright.
You explain that.
Yeah, so normally you guys want to set a vortex right over here. Go ahead, put the switch, and you can just go ahead and charge it. The orbs don't do any damage to you if you dash through it, so you can take advantage of that. When the next wave starts, you can go ahead and set your next vortex. Take in mind that you have enough time to detonate your quills right after you place your vortex and still charge up your voltage. So you're able to like fire the quills at the center of your vortex. Oh, another technique you guys could do there is also leave one slag till the very end and then let it die via vortex, and then what you can do is charge up your blitz needle so that by the time it dies you can charge the Trojan that spawns, which normally faces anywhere south of where my knight is. Anywhere like here is normally where you see the Trojan.
Also, I find like really easy that when he went down when he put the vortex, but he can normally just go up and then one charge should kill them all.
Either way, from the side of the top they both work.
Yeah.
But yeah, as long as you get them all in one big group. That's the big key. So here, everything here dies pretty much with like easily one charge and then a hammer combo. Oh, he lived barely. I just like freeing up the Trojan instantly. Oh, it's okay. But yeah, normally it's just nice to free him up, let him charge to dash towards you, or just simply use his regular attack, and then you just deal with a Trojan. Now you normally deal with a Trojan, just charge it behind its back.
Yeah, boy.
I mean, you can easily do it with voltage charges if you like angle them a bit differently. I'll demonstrate that in the next room. I'll do the room with the two Trojans, and you can show them how to do the room with the one Trojan in the bottom left. Reason being is because I want to show these guys how to kill Trojans with like using your voltage and your hammer and not using your soaker. So here, as you can
see, for people who are not rich.
Yeah. So normally I like going after the slimes first or the Trojan first depending on what he done. This time the Trojan was stuck, but sometimes he goes straight for the attack. If you do the charge on an angle, see, it did literally 50% of his health, and the shock prevents him from moving at times. And then he goes for the bulk up, and you can just go ahead and finish him off. The voltage is actually really nice to use. Now I'll demonstrate the hammer. Okay, you can also lure him out here. another cloak technique. It's just finding him, going behind his back, and using the dash that does a really high amount of damage to him. A lot. And you can pretty much just stealth take him out. So that's good for Masquerade users. Rob wants to demonstrate this room, I'm guessing, so I'll just spectate.
You just have to go like this here on the side. Raise ones, and then just go like that. And then charge again. And repeat the same process.
True. There's also something called fire dashing. You see how you can like avoid some damage right there by like dashing when the fire is about to tick.
Let them inspect us so they know what we're using and shit.
Alright. Well, I mean, I'm going for a full-on offensive set. Full cat for damage max on my swords, guns, and electron vortex. With swift steps too, meaning I get MSI VH. I'm running an additional elite quick draw module and an elite handgun focus since my blitz only has CTR high. So I'm running CTR max, ASI ultra, and damage max on my blitz. Everything else is damage max, ASI, VH, or ultra. Trade.
No, we're good.
Rog is running BKC Chaos. Gives him damage ultra. Only one stage below max. Still hits hard. And then he's running a swift strike for some ASI along with his elite handgun focus and elite quick strike. So he's running some ASI on his blitz as well. So he has ASI ultra. And then CTR max. Damage max, I think, right? Or was it? Mm-hmm. No, it's damage ultra. Yeah, he's running swift steps. It's ultra, isn't it? Because...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's ultra. It's ultra. But yeah, still, like... Oh, this guy did this room? No, he didn't. Okay, so this room, the Trojan spawns right over here. You can just time the button.
But if you're doing, like... If you're doing a duel, then someone can come here and charge up.
Yeah.
But if you're soloing, then what you want to do is...
You go down, and then you aggro him. Pretty much. Then you got like a little spot here in the corner that you can just kill opponents. You can just like bring them there if you want, or you can just group them up, grab the loot, and then grab your sprite. Oh wow, I could actually fit through there? Jeez, mini skinny. You know? The speed up is really nice and helpful here. No one really goes to this room right here. Like, I'll still show you guys how to do it, but normally people don't like really do much with this room because there's not much crowns in it, and it takes a while to get down to the very bottom. But I'll show you guys. We'll spawn here.
If you're going to that room, then I'd recommend having a dragon.
Yeah, because you're gonna speed through everything with the backfire if you time it correctly. But I'll show these guys the Masquerade way.
Mm.
It's just a quick takeout. And then you can just go on ahead and continue to... Oh! This side's blocked. Rip. Just continue your way on up. I can make it here. It's important to stay on the far left or the far right when you're going north or south, and it's important to stay on the far south or far north if you're going east or west. So, like, stay on the left side or the right side if you're going up or down, pretty much. And stay on the top or the bottom if you're going left or right. And that way you avoid wheels. Even if you don't see them, you won't get hit by them. You hit me somehow. Same way it happens in lockdown when you get the double knockouts. Playing with one hand, eating with the other hand. OP, isn't it? Peanut butter sandwiches. Oh, this nigga.
Holy shit.
How'd I take damage though? What did I take damage from, bro? Does that make any sense to you? Like, I shouldn't have taken no damage. That's hilarious. But see, the guy's going good. We're showing everyone what they gotta do.
Yeah.
Because what I'm thinking is that after we show the tutorial, we can pretty much do another video where we're actually doing a serious speedrun and we can show them how effective it is when we apply what we're teaching them. We can do that after, like... Because I just don't want to, like, do everything super quick and then be explaining it while I'm, like, on the next task. Because then they'll be like, wait, hold on, how do you do this, how do you do that? So I'm slowing it down so that they can understand everything. That's harsh.
I was about to suggest that we should do the run.
Yeah, we will.
You just charge up your vortex here.
Mm-hmm. You normally attack from the bottom, I normally attack from the top, so we can clear the wave with one round each time. That's like a system that we have. Normally the like 80% of Sparrow Knights players attack from the bottom anyway, so if you're ever in a party with more than two people, I highly recommend after they place the vortex to simply just go from the top and attack, because it'll really help out. Because like having three kills coming from one side is just not going to really help out the team, because then only the end is going to be hit by the burst, so they're all going to be living. And like the top, and then the ones at the front get super murked. It's like, okay, you can kill them all at once if just people divide their forces. That's why the strategy is called Divide and Conquer. Okay. We have two different routes. That's pretty much how you clear everything quick.
No, this is a technique I like to do. You lose a lot of health, but if you have track them, then you can do it.
Or you can just do it the regular way. I'm not even gonna make it this time because I started a bit late. Oh no, I barely made it. I forgot I'm running MSIVH. But I barely made it that time.
I'm doing that when everybody in the party, or most people in the party, have it. Not than just do it the normal way. Because you only lose your health for nothing.
Yeah.
But I just wanted to show you guys the thing. Your mini goes right, then I go left and center, and then just vortex
it. Mm-hmm. So, vortex, hammer dash, as you guys can see, it's highly effective. Now that he already cleared the Trojan, it's safe for me to go around the key area. Fight some more. Oh, he didn't?
Right.
I thought you cleared the Trojan, boy!
Oh, that's last.
I swear I saw you blitzing something.
Nah.
Oh, I must be high.
You always are, boy.
When you have so much health that you get careless. Me right now. Alright. You can just loot candles, you get some more moonays, not much. This one you can time, as soon as the spikes go down, you can just run on across and just smack everything real quick with a charge. Just smack it towards the direction of the middle, you know, don't hit it away from the vortex, cause like, I know it's a super big piss off, the people who like, put down a vortex and then like, they combo the monsters outside of the range, it's like, dude. Like, I'm trying to put the vortex down to help you guys, you know? So that's my rule of thumb for you guys. It's like, if you're in a party and someone's using a vortex, be mindful of it. If you have a combustor charge, do take note that your charge knocks back. So try and compensate by, like, knocking them into the middle or something, you know? So then it makes the run quicker for everyone. But it's like really just posting up a vortex after most of the waves. He's gonna post one right here. Just gonna go ahead blitz in the middle right before the vortex activates. If you guys do that, you're able to hit everything at once. Also, as as I mentioned before, if you use your quills, you can pretty much quill everything in the middle as well. Hammer charges are interesting. You can use them in the middle of vortexes too, they do work. But I mean, the voltage is just so much better, so... Yeah. You might as well just be sticking to it, and just spamming your charges.
It's just really super OP. F26 is where you want to double.
Mm-hmm.
You have F26. You have two chances of doubling, so... I'll get into that later.
Alright. Someone left? Okay.
Yeah, but oof.
Oh.
Poor guy.
So normally people like send water right up here from the base so you can water that one last little tile of fire. So when you get up there, you are actually able to go on ahead without water and just water this. One person can go up and like as they pass the first half they just summon a Trojan.
And then you pretty much just get rid of the turrets.
Exactly. They're tier 2 flamethrowers, so like they die really quickly. You don't have to waste much on them. Then from there you can just go ahead, take advantage of someone's vortex. Use your cloak and just smash everything up in the middle.
That would be it.
Rip.
Now here, this is a technique with vortex for this part, where you just use your barrier like this and then charge vortex up. And then the other guy takes the...
I'm lagging like crazy, dude. Holy cow.
Right now.
Yeah. So now what I like doing is placing down a vortex on each side over here so that enables you to have a clearer path to walk.
Now, what's important is when you're clearing up, if you want to double, you need to leave one, so I'm going to just leave this guy out.
Yeah. You can leave him.
So make sure that your partner clears out everything, then you have to stand right here. And stand like this. Then the other guy kills him, and then that would be the double.
There's one thing on the ground, hold up.
Okay.
Alright. So that should be it. Yep, and there's your double. So that's the technique that he was trying to do earlier. And then you can also just go ahead and set down your vortex, and then you could just pop all the wolvers in like one charge. There's one that barely lived.
We do this because sometimes it can be annoying that you're trying to blitz them and they just keep like
popping all over the place.
Yeah.
So it just tells them to sit there as down, boy.
Hmm. I'm also very careless about my HP, so don't judge me.
Ooh, you better water that. Oh my god, I didn't get water, it's okay. I have ample health right now, so it's fine. Got health capsules.
It's on the other side, rip.
Oh, let's go Kobe this real quick. And then wait, what? What the what kind of Kobe was that, bro? I'm gonna show you a real Kobe next time then, bro. Screw it, like. Yo, you're gonna pop all the boxes and I'm gonna give you guys the biggest Kobe you've ever freaking seen, bro. Like, not having that shit, boy. Cole fucking B, bro. Like, wasn't having that. Alright.
Come out here, one person charged up for the Trojan, and then the other one, if he or she has a vortex skull like this side. So that would be me, and then he just takes the Trojan real quick. Yeah. Then when he goes left, I do my...
I just give him some excess quills, because I only have three, so like it doesn't take much to kill them. As you can see, and then you just go ahead and prep for the next... Trojan. He may spawn a bit weird because I don't have time to break this. No, he spawned perfect. And now the mass of the slag spawn on the left hand side in this wave.
I'll leave this guy. No. You can come loot.
Okay, I'll do it this time.
Stand here. Like
I got it. Oh no. I was so freaking close, but these guys spawned them wrong. But it's okay.
Yeah.
You guys understand the concept of it. Alright. I normally only go through the spikes, just cause if you go on fire then that's just rip, in cat at least. You used to see my aura trace. Wee. This guy said slash already. Let's go, dog. Oh yeah, now we get to show these guys how to crush Vanaduke. The part I'm actually waiting for. So this is how you guys crush Vanaduke. Like, when I say crush, I mean like utterly like just decimate him so bad that he doesn't want to talk about his experiences with his mom. Okay, like, let's go, dark.
Alright, so Vanaduke, Masquerade, and a Dragon is like the perfect combination because Minikin Cloak and I can just easily use my third technique.
Yeah, his frenzied firestorm.
So we'll just show you guys right now.
Alright.
How to slaughter Venom.
You have a poison vial?
No, but that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
So, the first thing you got like this.
I normally just go for the quills if you don't have
a barrier there. We get a boost. And then we just charge at him.
Oh, and then I just dash, but okay. I'll water.
No, we need waters. And then we just like charge him. Normally, if he can cloak, he would take only two charges, but If not, then the first person to charge has to charge twice.
Normally putting a stun vial after the charge allows you to charge up again as he's going for the hit. Like that, meaning that he can stay in one place. Or meaning that right now he's gonna need to be watered. See? And then we can... Wait, why is my thing not working? Okay, you got the water or me?
Yeah.
Alright.
So see, me charge once and then I charge twice and that would be the kill.
Indeed. And technically, if I was able to get there sooner, I would be able to do two. Looking at Vanaduke's health right now.
Holy shit,
the cloak is all he really needs. I'm just gonna wait for him to go for another attack. Okay, now it's safe. Screw it.
That's it.
Yeah, like, I was just waiting for him to do an attack. But I mean... He ended up doing a dash, so that pretty much screwed himself over.
3, 2, 1.
Backfire.
Yep.
Oh man. Alright. So that's pretty much a quick FSC tutorial. Techniques you guys can do to like speed things up. So, like, we'll just repeat the Vanna process itself, just because it may be complex. So, normally if you're running damage ultra or damage max blitz needles, all you need to do is charge the mask 2 times if it is poisoned, or if one person has the firestorm boost, okay? 2 damage max poison blitz charges is pretty much enough, literally. Now, if it's going to be the mask stage 2, that will not be enough. You would need to have 3 charges, meaning that the person who's watering is going to do 1 charge, and the person who had it already charged is going to release 2 charges on it. So, like, as soon as it gets watered, they release it, and then they charge again, and they fire it off within 3 seconds. So that's your job. Think of it like this. Whenever somebody's in your party, whenever someone's in your party and they're about to water for you, your job is to release your charge as soon as they water it so you can charge again. Because half the time, the person who waters it is unable to charge twice. I'm able to because I'm running an extra ASI Trink, so I'm running ASI Ultra CTR Max. You can pull it off with just ASI High if you like really, really get the timing and you have CTR Max, though. It's more difficult. Trust me, it's more difficult, almost impossible. But when you do like 2 blitzes between 1 hammer of Vanna, that's more easy to do with just a Swift Strike Buckler. Like, I mean, like, as he's swinging down, you're charging again and releasing it before he swings again. It's pretty much 2 charges with 1 swing. But yeah, man. It's really the guide for FSC, how to do it. We'll do a run and we'll show you guys how quickly it really takes us to do just 1 run of FSC. Like, it's hella quick, boy. Alright.
So I guess, subscribe.
Better subscribe to my channel. This, I don't know. It feels like a leafy aura, but it's gemstones. It's weird. But it's interesting.